Welcome back to Bridge 4 Games. I'm Tom, and today let's take a closer look at the most common core in the VGC meta. If you're wondering where to start on team building, these three can really get you started, because you can drop them on pretty much any team, and it's a reliable start, and they can synergize with a lot of different Pokemon. Incineroar, for one, is the most used Pokemon in VGC since its release in Sword and Shield. Rillaboom is just a very reliable, hard-hitting physical Pokemon that has priority with in combination with its terrain move. It can also pivot. It's just a very good Pokemon, and Regieleki is the fastest Pokemon in the game with speed control and also pivot options as well. So today we're going to take a closer look at each one of these, what they do, why they are on so many teams, and really what makes them work so well together. Let's first talk about Regieleki and what makes such a seemingly predictable Pokemon so strong. Regieleki is by far the fastest Pokemon in the game, making it an immediate threat. Regieleki is so fast even that base 85 speed Pokemon can only outspeed Regieleki under Tailwind if they are a plus speed nature. Keeping that in mind, Regieleki is most likely going to be the first Pokemon on the board that attacks outside of priority. And that allows us to exploit its move pool. Its move pool being Electroweb, Thunderbolt, Volt Switch, and Protect most typically. With Volt Switch, you're able to hit in, get out of dodge before your opponent is able to get their moves off. With Electroweb, you can opt to hit both Pokemon of your opponents, and that's also going to drop their speed. What makes it work really well with Incineroar and Rillaboom is that speed tier diversity, the speed control with Electroweb, and the ability to pivot back out while hitting for super stab damage. And by the way, I almost forgot about Transistor. Regieleki's ability increases the damage of electric type moves by 50%. Saying this another way, Regieleki, being an electric type Pokemon, gets the same type attack bonus of 50%, and then it's increased again by Transistor, its ability, making stab 225%. Even the bulkiest of water Pokemon are going to really have a hard time taking hits. Let's talk about Rillaboom next, and its most typical move pool is Grassy Glide, Fake Out, Drum Beating or Wood Hammer, High Horsepower, and U-Turn. Now, this move pool is going to be dependent based on your team composition overall, as well as what you're looking to try and do. One thing that I would say is I do like running dual grass type moves with Grassy Glide, and typically I run Drum Beating on mine in case we're facing down an opposing Kyogre that has a Serena on their team. We know that Queenly Majesty on their end is going to block the Grassy Glide. We can still get a move off and hit four super effective into that Kyogre. The grass type coverage, though, does help Regieleki and Incineroar very well, as the most common way to hit those two is going to be with ground type moves, or in Incineroar's case, water type moves as well. In the opposite direction, the ice, flying, and fire moves that Rillaboom doesn't want to take, Incineroar is going to be able to tank those pretty well. So being able to kind of pivot around, switch around, and really position your Pokemon to take less damage is really going to help you out. Grassy Surge, real quick, puts up the grassy terrain. That's the most commonly used ability for Rillaboom, and that means that for 5 turns, grass-type attacks are increased by 30%, and at the end of the turn, Pokemon will gain 1/16th of their health back. In addition, when Grassy Surge is active, Grassy Glide gains priority of +1. Meaning that regardless of what the speed is, whether we're under Tailwind or we're under Trick Room, Rillaboom a lot of times is going to be attacking first. So really good things on that end, and certainly something to watch out for if you are opposing them. This can also help flip the terrain too if you're facing down Pokemon that are using like a psychic terrain, like an Indeedee. You can bring in Rillaboom and kind of disrupt your opponent's plans by flipping that into the grass. Rillaboom also has the ability to fake out. Again, flinching your opponent helps significantly with field positioning. A lot of times what we see is if you know that a fake out user comes into play, our opponents are going to possibly even protect for a turn. So that gives you kind of a turn to set up, if you will, almost like a dead turn for them, which can be beneficial if you are playing it right. Commonly used items on Rillaboom, again, are kind of going to be dependent on your team composition, but we see a lot of choice band, you know, with Grassy Glide being a big thing, Assault Vest, and Rose Incense, and just to kind of give a little bit of why I would use a Rose Incense and what that does to Rillaboom's stab attack is grassy terrain giving a 30% increase to grass type moves increased with the stab increased by Rose Incense, which is a 20% increase, puts that stab for in under grassy terrain at 234%, right? So Rillaboom is going to be swinging very hard, even into Pokemon that can resist or do resist grass-type moves, can still take a chunk of damage. Let's talk about Incineroar, and its primary move pool is going to be Flare Blitz, Fake Out, Parting Shot, and then really for the fourth move, I think trainers are going in tons of different directions, right? It could be Throat Chop, usually over Darkest Lariat. Nowadays, Throat Chop is going to stop a lot of those sound-based moves from going off the following turn, such as Snarl, such as Roar, and others, Hyper Voice, etc. As well, Taunt and Will-O-Wisp, Roar, those are all versatile moves, and those are going to be a little bit more dependent on the team composition, but it does have access to a pretty wide array of moves, Incineroar does. Its ability to obviously intimidate in combination with Fake Out and with pivoting out with Parting Shot can come back in with Rillaboom. Such a strong combination. And really, Incineroar unchecked really can snowball on your team if you're facing one, or you know, your opponent's team if it's letting you just keep getting intimidates off. If they have a physical oriented team. As well, we talked about the partners that can pivot with it. It can just be a downright painful experience if you're trying to swing into Incineroar with a hard water type move, only for Rillaboom to come in. It does barely anything. Then you try and hit it with a fire type move and Rillaboom switches into Incineroar. It's just you got to watch out when that combination is there and pick your shots for when you're going to swing in for super effective, knowing that they really cover each other so well. You know, that can also leave opponents chasing knockouts while your partner is kind of free to set up and move. Because of the pressure put on with Fake Out, with Parting Shot, with Intimidate, this can also lead to you being able to set up a little bit more freely with your partner Mon, right? So we talk about this being a common core. You know, other things can then take the opportunity to get set up and get in position while your opponent is focusing in on this combination. So definitely keep an eye out for that. Incineroar is also, you know, incredibly bulky. It's hard to Oko in the format. I think, you know, other than maybe Zacian with a close combat, it's going to be pretty hard to take out. I guess an Earth Power, from some Landorus are going to be able to do that as well. But, you know, it's not an easy Pokemon to Oko. It's typically going to be a little bit more of a defensive nature. It's got a pretty high attack stat naturally, so it can still hit pretty hard while committing more points into those defensive stats. So I think common items on Incineroar, we're going to see a lot of berries. We're going to see citrus berries. We're going to see figgy berries. You may see a resist berry here and there. Also, you know, things like safety goggle to make sure that it can land attacks, not get put to sleep by Amoongus or by Volcarona, not going to draw attacks away with Rage Powder. You know, as well, we can, depending on the set, see an Assault Vest if, you know, to make sure that it can tank some more of those hits a little bit more easily. Something that's, you know, popping up a little bit more to check this combo is Entei and Suicune, which have the Inner Focus ability, meaning that it won't have its attack stat dropped from Intimidate, and they will not flinch from a Fake Out. So make sure that we're aware of those things, you know, coming out and being a little bit more relevant. But this is just, like I said, a good breakdown for these folks and kind of how people are running them. So I hope you found this video informative. Just a quick breakdown on these three, the most commonly used Pokemon in the format right now, and hope it helps with your team building endeavors. If you like the content that Mike Blaine and I are putting together on Bridge 4 Games, please consider subscribing and leaving a like on the video. If there's anything that you want to see in a Common Core breakdown, please leave it in the comments section down below. But for Bridge 4 Games, I'm Tom, and we'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.